Let's move on to the Diamondbacks. The Diamondbacks are a team that I personally think they're going to be the second in the NL West. I don't think that there's even a chance anybody gets close to them. And I think they'll be wild card in this year for sure. I mean, we got Gallen. Remember, Gallen was on the Marlins. Yep. He was an absolute ace when he came over here on the Diamondbacks. 2.89 ERA in eight starts. And they got Bumgarner. Now, Bumgarner's not an elite pitcher by any means, but he's a guy who can win games, and they didn't pay so much for him. So he's a good piece to add that was relatively cheap, and he's got to be kind of excited to get out of the fucking dumpster fire that's the Giants over there. We know Ketel Marte is an absolute star. He's been progressively getting better in the last 2 years, each season metric-wise. They got Starlin Marte, who's also pretty good. We know he can slam the ball out of the park. And then we got that guy Walker, who took Goldschmidt's place, right, at first base. And he actually hits at a slugging rate higher than Goldschmidt did in his previous year in Arizona. So he's another piece of this offense, which I thought was, you know, a little bit spotty last year, that may be able to do some work. We had the epic meltdowns with these guys too. The fucking whole NL West epic bullpen meltdown. That should be the name of the community these guys belong to, because we had Archie Bradley absolutely hit a wall. We had Greg Holland, who blew some of the most embarrassing, like, I think he had two walk-off, like, loaded base walk-off that he loaded every guy on the base. I think that happened twice, and he was just slammed, I remember, for like a couple weeks, like on anything you'd read about MLB, he's gonna just thrash. But at the same time, this team, it definitely has talent. It has enough pitching. Baumgartner, oh man, leak is leaky. Ray and Weaver, I don't know what you get with all that, but I think that this is the number two team in the NL West. And what is that win total at, Joey, just so we can kind of give some context? You know, I don't do this thing, but
84.5.
That's relatively attainable.
They had 85 wins last year.
Right, and that's relatively attainable, and it's very much a similar lineup. And if you got to think that if they didn't blow some of those saves, it were like really, really bad save, you know, walking off two guys to get – you have to walk two guys off to lose the game.
Yep.
Loading every guy up. So I think they could exceed that, and I expect them to do similar work to last year, hopefully with a little bit of better bullpen situation, hopefully get that offense going a little harder. But they're definitely going to be number two in the NL West. What are your thoughts over here, Joey, on these D-backs?
I agree 100%. This is a bet I already put in, over 84.5 wins for the Arizona Diamondbacks. Obviously, Mad Bum, he's only 30, but he eats up innings. Robbie Ray is a little bit of a question mark. Mike Leake, he had at least 175 innings the last 8 years. So that's another guy eating innings. Zach Gallen, as you mentioned, acquired from Miami. I'm pretty high on him as well. And then they either got as a five, Luke Weaver or Merrill Kelly. The bullpen's a little bit shaky, as you mentioned. They did add Hector Rendon and Junior Guerrero from the White Sox and then Milwaukee. So that should help a little bit. And then they added their offense. Obviously, they added Starlin Marte, but Eduardo Escobar is probably the best unknown player. Last year, he had 35 homers, 118 RBIs in the three spot. He's like somewhat of a smaller guy. And then they got Christian Walker behind him. David Peralta, who I'm really high on as well. They just signed him to a three-year, $22 million extension. And then they added Cole Calhoun as well. So I think this team is second in the NL West as well. And I mean, their odds to win the division plus 800 might be worth a little sprinkle there, but I'm definitely going to – I already put them in for over 84.5 wins team total.
Right on. I think it's hittable. DJ, you're back. What's up, dude? What do you think about these D-backs?
Man? Y'all just stole the show and went away, man. The corona knocked me out, man. I had to go get some toilet tissue, man.
Oh!
Toilet tissue. Look at that. Look at that.
Put that away, bro.
Look at that. Toilet tissue. Oh, yeah. Don't let nobody know I got toilet tissue.
Yeah, man. You're about to get rolled up on
it. I'm going to get jacked. Oh, shit. Let me wipe my screen again. Oh, man. How you feeling, Parlay?
I'm good, man. I'm excited that we got the UFC on early today. Actually,
that's right.
I don't have work today or tomorrow, so I'm excited to just get hopefully get a crowd of people trying to do something. Everybody's been isolating themselves like a complete fucking. I don't even want to get into this political nonsense about this whole situation because this is not what we're here for. But yeah, we're just trying to get live on these UFC fights. Smash some Coors and Miller Lite. Maybe a little White Claw.
Gotta get the White Claw. Creepy.
I don't know, man. It's going to be a fun day, DJ. How are you feeling this morning?
Oh, man. Same old 1 and 2 for me, man. You know, I'm taking this time to take a break because, you know, I've been going, you know, the shows and all that stuff since last year. And, you know, if they give me a break right here, I'm going to take the time and study up, man. I was really teed in on my XFL. I was learning about the Team 9 in the XFL. They have Team 9 that they had sitting around, and after the fifth week, each team gets 5 more players. You know, I dissected all out. I seen that, you know, teams were going to their weak point, so it was letting you know where they were weak at. So I was excited for XFL, and I thought McMahon over there would be like, hey, I got the big pockets. I don't got to shut down. I need this type of publicity to move this thing where I wanted to go. And of course, probably legally wise, he had to shut it down too. So yeah. I don't know what I'm gonna do today. I mean, I'm not an advocate of just jumping in, you know, DJing style just to have some money on the line and all that. I mean, when you like us, you've been gambling for years, man. It's that little part of rush to have money down just to have money down. I've made that mistake so many times that, you know, I'm just not going to do it no more. But to tell you the truth, though, to occupy my time, to take care of my itch, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to go back to something I was doing for a while that I stopped, and I'm going to go back doing a little esports, man. I endeavor in the esports from every now and then because they have places you can go on esports. You can actually cap it down a little bit, you know, see who I was playing the one with the shooting game. I was playing, you know, how many kills they get per, you know, the percentage, you know, kind of, you know, make it a little fun for me, but nothing major, like a fourth of a unit just playing around, man. But
man, I'd rather get a coronavirus and watch some fucking bet on some esports.
Oh, man. When I got into it, it was crazy, man. I find myself sitting there watching somebody play a video game. I'm like, damn. I'm like, come on, get them. We got to come back. It's crazy, but
got back from the med shop. Understandable, man.
Yeah,
understandable.
I'll tweak out on that for a little while just to stay occupied. I'm not going to jump into soccer. I don't bet soccer. I'm not going to jump into UFC, and I don't bet that. If I do decide to lay something, it's going to be because of one of my guys, like you guys, put me on to something, and I say, hey, let me put a little money
right
in the homie. But other than that, man, I'm going to chill, man. Have fun. Enjoy my family and keep drinking these drinks. And guess what, Parlay? I started drinking the spiked seltzers, man.
Whoa, man. You got the White Claw turn up time, man.
I joined the White Claw Nation, man.
Got the bro special, dude.
Yeah, man. I can't believe it, man. But they're wonderful. Yeah, they're all wonderful. Right. They're only a few carbs. They're tasty, you know?
Absolutely delish.
You know, you have to take a shot in between every now and then just to keep the party rolling, though. But anyways, Diamondbacks, man, I don't know. I'm going to start marking down the trend here that these teams that are picked number 2 in these divisions are the ones, man. That's where you want to lay the money because one of them going to shine. And they fall in the category, like I told you guys before, I like teams that invest in the team and try to make a difference. You know, they went Baumgartner. They're trying to do something to become that number one team. And I'm all for it. I'm all for them wins to go over. I like Baumgartner as a leader on the team. Like, he has some kind of effect. He knows how to rally the troops and all that kind of stuff. So I like Baumgartner over there. Coming up with the nice pitching they got going. They even got options on the fifth spot, which makes it even more fun for them. You know what I'm saying? Maybe they get some young guys to do something. But, yeah, definitely following the Diamondback train with y'all.
Yeah, they have big bat positions in the pipeline too. You know what I mean? Like position players. So these Diamondbacks actually could, if that pitching – what I expect this offense to really pick up, if that pitching can contain, I think that this is a team that is actually in the future going to start contending with the Dodgers here. I really don't see these other three teams going nowhere, except the Padres, maybe.
Well, in the words of the great Noli Knows, making unders great, in the NL, you know, the magic number is 7, you know what I'm saying? And so you don't really need a lot of bats. I mean, you talk about scoring 3-4 runs a game can get you by at some spots in the season. So bats are not, you know, pitching over in this side, it almost means everything. The bats just help get it going a little bit further, you know what I'm saying?
That's why the Dodgers are there. The Dodgers are there because they have those bats, and if Arizona could get some of that, man, this is gonna be a funner division than it is right now, where it's real one-sided.
Yeah, it is one-sided. I totally agree. But that one-sided all comes from teams that are proactive out there doing stuff. And the Dodgers are already a great team. You know, they saw a wide opening for Betts and said, come on over here. So, you know, I definitely, you know, ask my team too. But I admire that part of the Dodgers too. But I don't know. I live in L.A. I hear all the naysayers of the Dodgers. And, the Dodgers could be one of those teams that just can't never get it right. But I'm going to give them the benefit of the doubt since the Astros got caught with their hand in the cookie jar. And Kershaw really stunk up that series that year, and he did really well last year compared to, you know, what he had done before. So maybe they kind of tricked Kershaw, you know, out of his stuff right there, and maybe he's the real deal.
Now he had the highest walk rate and the highest FIP, fielding independent, basically the defensive metric of just pitching alone. He was bad last year all around, but I think it's age. I think Kershaw can't be Kershaw, but he can be Kershaw 0.5. You know, like
half. Yeah. Well, I'm saying maybe they misdiagnosed him because I was totally off of him. I was like, man, this guy really stinks up the field. Like he's a lot of too much value gave him to Kershaw, but last year he held it tight for a while, at least in the win columns. I'm not saying his pitching was great because he gave up plenty of runs, but
he got run support for sure. But,
he got you know, the Dodgers was knocking 9 runs after the 6. You know what I'm saying? So he got a lot of help in that too, but you know, he got the wins, you know, and that's the bottom line. You know, he got the wins. And I look at that sometimes when you put two pitchers against each other. And sometimes some pitchers, it almost seems like the players play bat better or play well when these pitchers are pitching, but they're not really the best pitchers. They give up plenty of runs all the time, but they get those W's, man, and those W's stand out in the long run. So, Kershaw and them over there. But, what's the next team? Poppy, you got us rocking and rolling. You got the energy today, man. I'm going to pass the torch to you, bro.
You're the host, DJ. This is you.
Banging sports talk. What up, though? Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share.